Now we shall present the screen and come back to this screen presentation now. This is what I am going to give you. 6.3, that is fourth question now. What is given? Let us check once again. Given is that lines PQ and RS intersect at T. Instead of lines, I took line segments as I already told you. RS and PQ, they intersect at T. Given are angle PRT 40 degrees, angle RPT 95 degrees, angle TSQ 75 degrees, and they are all marked in blue, pink and green color. You have to find what is SQT, that is marked in red now. It's a question. Okay. Now, for this, we need to find, suppose if you know in this triangle, this angle is known, if you know this angle also, you can find the third angle easily. So, to find this angle, we find its vertical opposite angle, which is easy to find because from this triangle, using angle sum property, this angle equal to sum of all the three angles minus sum of these two angles. That is what is the first step now. So, we need to find the third angle in triangle PRT, that is angle PTR, angle PTR plus angle PRT plus angle RPT equal to 180 degrees, that is by angle sum property. So, PTR plus PRT is 40, RPT is 95, is equal to 180. So, sum of these two is 135, that is subtracted from 180 to get what is PTR. Now, second step is simple. QTS, angle QTS, this angle is equal to this one, that is PTR, because they are vertical opposite angles, that is equal to 45 degrees now. Now, two of the angles in this triangle we know. So, finding third angle is not a difficult thing. So, now in triangle SQT, angle SQT plus angle QTS plus angle TSQ equal to 180 degrees, that is by angle sum property, angle SQT equal to, not known, that is to be found, but QTS equal to 45 we found just now here, and TSQ is given 75 degrees. I am substituting all the two. Now, angle SQT equal to 180 degrees minus sum of these two, that is 120, it is 60 degrees. This is how we found the solution for this question 4 from exercise 6.3. Now, shall we move on to the next question now? Did you all understand this one? You may take a screenshot or note down quickly before I erase this. I'm going to close this now. Close. Now, yeah, somebody is talking. You can go ahead. Who is that? Any doubt? Any doubt? Now, question number 5 we are looking into now. Question number 5 I am opening again in GeoGebra. It is getting opened now. You all hold on. Question number 5, what is given? Let us just read. In this question, again, two lines PQ, a line segment PQ and a ray ST are, now just a minute, I will, now what is given from there, we will check. Line segment PQ and PS, line segment PS, they are perpendicular to each other. That means the angle here, QPS, what is the angle? Let us mark that angle now. Angle QPO, sorry, I'll mark the other way around. This one is a right angle. You can see it's a 90 degrees angle because those two are perpendicular. So here is a 90 degrees angle. You understand this much. Next, SQR, this is SQR, green color marked angle, that is 28 degrees. Angle QRT, okay, exterior angle per SQR is given 65 degrees, that is also marked in some other color here. You need to find, there are two more angles here marked as x and y. You have to find these values of x and y. To find the values of x and y. Now, to find x and y, it is a very simple activity. One more thing is given. Oh, sorry, I forgot to write that, I think. PQ is parallel to SR. PQ is parallel to SR. I'll write that also here. PQ is given parallel to SR. Okay? Parallel to SR. That is also given there. So, PQ is parallel to SR. When you say that this line and this line are parallel to each other, you can say something about the angle PQR and QRT. Can anybody tell that? Kavyanjali, Tanima, Vishnu, come on, open your mic and tell me.
They are alternate interior exterior angles.
Alternate interior angles, correct. Not exterior, interior only. Alternate interior only. Okay. Now these two lines, see this one and this one, they are parallel. So this QR is a transversal. Therefore, this angle and this angle are alternate interior angles. So you can see the formation of jet there. You can see the yellow color blink, you see. Could you see the blink in yellow color, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
One yellow color blink in the form of jet, could you see? Yeah. That is what is the alternate interior angles. X plus 28 and 65 make a pair of alternate interior angles. So, very easy. Now, X plus 28 is equal to 65 degrees because these two are equal. Therefore, X plus SQR is equal to QRT because those two are alternate pair of alternate interior angles. Let me write that also here in brackets. Alternate interior angles. AIA. Okay, I'll write that. Right. Now, X plus this is 28 is equal to 65. So, X equal to 65 minus 28, that is 37. So, value of x is obtained now. Simple. Now, what else you have to find? Here, the value of y. Value
alternate interior angle.
Alternate. No. They are not alternate interior angles.
Triangles, sir.
From angle sub property of triangle. This angle we know, this angle we know. Can't we find this angle? So, now, triangle SPQ plus x plus y is equal to 180. By angle sum property, by ASP, by, I will put a bracket here, by ASP for triangle. What triangle is this? Can you tell me what is the triangle there? Angle SPQ. Angle triangle SPQ.
Right. Triangle, triangle.
Triangle SPQ. For this triangle SPQ, we are now taking this 7
degrees.
Now SPQ is 90 degrees perpendicular, therefore 90 degrees. X we found 30 degrees plus y is not known, is equal to 180. Therefore sum of these two is 127. Y equal to 180 minus 127, that is 53 degrees. 53 degrees. Now did you all understand what is this problem? Only two steps. First step,
yes, you,
let me explain from the beginning again. Now, this is the problem given, say figure given, and what is given is PQ is perpendicular to PS, therefore the angle here QPS or SPQ equal to 90 degrees. Next, we also are given PQ is parallel to SR. PQ is parallel to SR, that means this line and this line, they are parallel to each other. Automatically QR will be the transversal. When QR is a transversal, this angle PQR and QRT will be the alternate interior angles. You can see the blink there. Now, therefore, that PQR is nothing but x plus 28. X plus SQR equal to 65 degrees, that is QRT, 65 degrees. So x plus 28 is 65, x equal to 65 minus 28, that is 37 degrees. Now, that next angle, why you have to find, you use angle sum property for the triangle SPQ, wherein angle SPQ plus x plus y is equal to 180 by angle sum property. Therefore, 90 plus 37, that is 127, is taken away from 180 to get the value of y as 53 degrees. Did you all get this problem? Any doubt? Venugopal?
No, sir.
No doubt. Yashwant?
No, sir.
Yashwant? Any doubt? Yashwant, talk to me. You are opening and not talking.
Sir, I am talking, sir.
Talking? You are not, I am not able to listen, then be louder then.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Tejesh, any doubt? Tejesh? Tejesh?
No, sir.
No doubt. Okay, good. Now, let us...
Sir, I am having a doubt, sir.
Who is this? Venkatesh?
Sir, Karunya, sir.
Tell me, Karunya.
Where? Sir, the angle PS and SR, sir, S angle that it will be 90 degrees, sir.
Yeah, exactly, because they are perpendicular to each other. PQ and PS, they are perpendicular to each other. That means they are making these two sides are making an angle 90 degrees. Then only they are called perpendicular, is it not?
Yes, sir.
That symbol, sir, is whenever you see this rectangular symbol, it is automatically 90 degrees. Yes. Okay, next.
Sir, angle PQRSR is 28 degrees, no, sir. Sir, 28 degrees, x is linear pair, no, sir.
28 and x are linear pair. How? Linear pair means they should be, see, this line should be here, like this. On a line, there should be, see, I will show you one linear pair here. Okay. Right, one ray I will take here, from here I will take, see, this is what is linear pair, angle here, this side and that side, they are linear pair. See, now you can see the linear pair moving like this, is it not?
Yes, sir.
Then linear pair is different. Now this angle, okay, one second, I will undo it. This angle here and this angle here, suppose these two are linear pair, 130 and this one. And if I move this, the angles will be changing. You see, are they changing or not?
Yes, sir.
Those two are linear pair. How can these two are linear pair? They are not linear pair. They are adjacent angles. They are adjacent angles. You understand, children? So, linear pair means the sum should be 180 degrees. They are not 180 degrees. It is not given anywhere. Okay? Okay then. We will close this. Instead, of course, I don't say.
Sir.
And this. I will undo this. Okay. Undoing is like this. Anyway, I will save this one first. Save. I will go back to the next question now. Here we go. That is question number 6. Question number 6. Each question now, children, I am going to show you on the screen. I have drawn this using the software called GeoGebra. So, in GeoGebra, drawing these is a bit easy. Of course, now we will go for a construction protocol. Up to here we will go. Right. This is the picture given, children, all of you look. In triangle, there is a triangle PQR and QR, the side QR is extended up to R, up to S, and an exterior angle is formed here, PRS. And for that PRS, a bisector is taken, angle bisector is taken. Angle bisector means a line, a ray or line segment making the angle into two equal parts. These two are equal now. Similarly, the angle bisector of PQR, this is QT, these two are joining here at T. QT, angle bisector of angle PQR, and RT, angle bisector of angle PRS, these two are meeting at T. Meeting at T. And these two angles are equal, these two angles are equal, and the markings are done separately. Now what is given? We will understand. QR and QR of triangle PQR is produced to S. That means extended up to S. QT, the bisector of PQR. QT, bisector of PQR, this one. And TR, bisector of PRS, this one. Okay? Now, what is to be found now? You have to prove here. No finding, proving. Angle T, QTR. QTR is this angle. Okay? That angle, this angle is half of this angle QPR, this one. Okay? That's what we have to prove. See, this smaller purple color angle is half of this one. It is going to be half, of course. True. Let us check that one now. To prove this one, we take the help of exterior angle property. What property, children? Exterior angle property. Pavani, repeat. Repeat, Pavani, what property are we using here? Quickly, it is already 8:52. Exterior angle property, Pavani did not repeat actually. Okay. Now, here we go. Exterior angle property for this one we use QTR. QTR is one of the angles of triangle QTR, and TQR is the other angle. And this one, to find this angle, like this we'll write. Angle QTR, QTR, this angle is equal to this entire angle for this one, the exterior angle TRS minus this angle. Because exterior angle is equal to sum of its opposite interior angles. Sum of this pink purple color angle plus blue color angle is this angle. What is this one only? This one only. I will mark this angle alone with the green color completely. I will fill that angle. Here this purple angle and this blue angle is equal to green angle here. Alright. Now, next what? Next, what is TRS? This green color angle is half of this full PRS angle. Half of PRS. And what is TQR? TQR, angle TQR, TQR, this angle is half of this PQR, PQS, PQS or PQR, you can say, this angle. Okay? PQS also you can say, PQR also we can say. Next, now we will write this one. Did you understand this step, children? TRS is equal to TRS, TRS is half of PRS, and TQR, TQR is half of PQR or PQS we can say. Okay, next step. This PQS, PRS is, PRS is again sum of the opposite interior angles, that is angle PQR, this angle, plus angle QPR, this angle. Actually, let me write PQR here so that there won't be any confusion. Instead of PQS, PQR, I am writing both are same angles. Okay, now this half of PQR. Now, here we will expand this one. Half PQR plus half QPR minus half QPR. QPR, QPR will be cancelled and sorry, PQR, PQR will be cancelled. Only we'll be left with QPR. So next step, simple, half of PQR plus half of QPR minus half of PQR. This PQR and this PQR, they are same. So we cancel them. This is positive, this is negative. We'll cancel them. We are left with only the angle QPR. Now the proof has come already. Angle QTR is equal to, angle QTR is equal to, this angle is equal to half of QPR. We theoretically proved this. We theoretically proved this. Okay. Now, children, you can also check the angles here if you want, whether they are half or not. Let me tell the value here. What is the value? 73 point it is coming. Options I will, okay, let it be. And this one, what is the value I want to check here? So 36.57. Okay, if you see 36 into 36, 72. So it is 2 times actually. So angle QTR is half of angle QPR, we proved this now. You understand? By measurement also the same. Okay, all of you take a screenshot of this one or write it immediately. In the meanwhile, I will go for a screen share from my mobile so that we will have a quick attendance roll call. Okay, I think I have to stop this screen share. I'll stop this.